So hello everyone, welcome. Today I'm interviewing Alice from Australia. She's a female engineer in environmental engineering doing her master's here at ETH with me. So welcome.
Hi.
So if you guys like this video, please make sure to like it and subscribe and comment any more questions that you have below, anything that I didn't touch on, or any other questions that you have for Alice. So your project at ETH, is it anything specific?
Yeah, well, I'm doing a master's thesis project, and I'm really interested in studying the surface and groundwater interactions, especially in rivers and streams. I'm looking into a project which is doing surface and groundwater modeling on an alpine river valley, which has been influenced by hydropower. So what I'm specifically focusing on with my project is trying to get a good representation of the groundwater in this system so that this model can be used to try and develop environmental flow releases, like trying to be able to use the river water for hydropower, but also while protecting the environment.
Wow, that's awesome. I feel like you're super... superwoman.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm trying not to.
So you like it, and you're going to pursue it after your master's degree. What is the plan after your master's degree?
So after my master's degree, I want to go back into industry again.
In Australia?
Yeah, so I've considered, with engineering, it's a really mobile degree. You can work in almost any country with the same qualifications, except it's the challenge for me was I want to work in Europe, but I'm not very good with languages. So that's my hurdle. It's not the career, it's just my lack of languages. So I've decided to move to New Zealand afterwards and try and get a job as a water resource engineer in New Zealand.
Oh, that's so cool. Yeah. I go kayaking in New Zealand.
Oh, yeah.
And yeah, there's a lot of rivers there that need saving.
Yeah, I hope so.
So I'll come visit you for sure,
please.
When I come kayak. Yeah. So a lot of languages here in Europe or just in Switzerland? Because I know here we need to speak German.
Yeah, well, I guess being from Australia, I only speak English. And me and my partner looked into moving to countries, especially we looked into Germany, except it just sounded really challenging to get a professional job where you don't speak the native language fluently. And we considered moving to England, but I just don't really like England. We considered Canada, but you don't get paid as much.
Yeah, that's true. Was your mom correct about engineering, you always find a job?
I think she was just saying that compared to other career choices, like I was thinking of studying history or the arts because I really like writing, but then sometimes it's a bit difficult to get a job in those industries. I guess being a female in engineering, also what I've noticed is a lot of doors open up for you. You get like my workplace where I used to work at, they have a gender equality policy where they try to encourage, they're working towards having equal males and females in management positions in 20 years. So I guess there's always an opportunity, especially for women. People are trying really hard to increase women in engineering. So I guess, yeah, for me, I've always had a job.
Do you have any specific advice for girls that want to pursue this field in environmental engineering or engineering in general?
I guess my key advice is if you're just beginning university and you've chosen to do engineering, you should really stick it out until the third or fourth year of the degree, because the first 2 years, they generally be...
they suck.
Yeah, they're really heavy maths and physics and computer science focus. And it's not until you get to the end of the degree that you really get to specialize in the area that you're interested in. Yeah, another piece of advice would be to try and learn computer coding as much as possible. It seems really daunting, and I'm not very good with computers, but I work with computers every day, and it's a skill that you can learn, and it's something that can really help you in your career because it is difficult and a lot of people don't like it. So then... what I found, I do computer modeling and I do a lot of coding with it. I've always got a job because no one else wants to do it.
Yeah.
It's not as hard.
Yeah. I think programming is the most, probably the like most valuable skill set you could have as an employee.
Yeah, especially these days.
Yeah.
What I found was engineering is really collaborative. So we had a really good group in my bachelor's degree, and it was a really small year group. We only had 15 students, and everyone worked together. And no, it's not very competitive. That's what I found. I have friends who did studied law and accounting and finance, and now in their professional careers, it seems really competitive. So everyone's trying to one-up you. People aren't always working together. Whereas in engineering, people seem to be generally a bit, I wouldn't say lazy, but they're not very, just a style of people.
Yeah.
Lots of people don't take the initiative. Lots of people, there could be a few introverts. It'd be quite easy to progress up different career paths if you were really focused and had a lot of energy.
Anything about women in STEM that we haven't touched on that you'd like to touch on?
Well, maybe just the amount of women. Like what I found in some of my classes at university, I had to study Java programming. I was one of three women out of about 70. So it can be really overwhelming. And it depends on what type of engineering or STEM you're studying. I know in electrical engineering, there's hardly, my brother had no females in his class.
Really?
Yeah, so I guess it's all changing, but it's just to be aware of it, because sometimes it can be a bit of a boys' club. In Australia, we call it getting ladsy. And they like
getting what?
Ladsy, like they're a lad.
Ah. Yeah.
Like sometimes it can feel a bit exclusive, and if you're a woman, they might treat you differently or not include you. When I moved into environmental engineering, it was 50-50. So if you're doing more of the sciencey-based or environmental, it tends to be a lot more women. But then when I moved into work, I worked in the water group, which is mainly civil engineers. So mainly it's 40-year-old middle-aged men.
Okay.
Everyone's really nice and encouraging. I've never felt any form of discrimination.
Okay.
But just sometimes you miss having women. But then I think it's really good also, because at my work, all of the women engineers, we kind of stuck together. So we formed our own group, which was the opposite. So we were being exclusive because it was just females. But no, I think it's just something you have to be aware of. And
if you guys liked this video, then please like it. If you have any comments or questions for Alice, please leave them below. If you want to hear more from Alice, then please click the link below to see the rest of her video. So thank you, Alice. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you enjoyed doing the interview.
I really appreciate the opportunity to help fellow women in engineering and STEM. I really hope that this has been useful. And if you have any more questions, just leave them in the comments. I'd be happy to answer them.